Welcome to the BHB Trilogy Podcast with your host, Beast, Hot Sauce, and Buckets.
Hey, welcome to the BHB Trilogy Podcast, episode 15. We're here with Buckets.
Hello.
And David Hernandez.
What's going on?
Now, a little bit of background information on David is he grew up in La Puente, California, attended St. Joseph and Bishop, went to Long Beach State. After that, he got a job at the Hyatt in Huntington Beach as an activities coordinator, and recently just transferred to the Hyatt in Denver as a human resources coordinator. So welcome, David. Welcome to the podcast. He's also my uncle, too. He's a huge Lakers, Dodgers, and Raiders fan.
That's right.
He goes to all the away games and home games. So are you going to any away games this year?
I wish I went to all the away games, but what did you say? Sorry.
Are you going to any away games this year?
For the Raiders? Yeah. I got Houston playing. Week 8, I think. And I'm going to Chicago in June for some baseball. Not for the Dodgers, though, just to check out some stadiums. So, checking out Wrigley Field, White Sox, I think it's, I don't know what the stadium's called. And then taking the train up to Milwaukee, check out that stadium. Be a good weekend.
It's nice. Are you happy with the Raiders pick they made yesterday?
All three, yeah.
You're happy with all of them?
All of them.
Even Clinton, what's his name?
Clinton Furrow.
Yeah, okay.
He's good.
Are you surprised?
Surprise for sure. Thought they were going to get another edge rusher, but they got everything they needed. I'm happy. We'll see what happens.
Nice. Tell us about your childhood.
Ooh, what do you want to know?
Like, how was it like growing up with Grammy and my mom?
Okay.
Like, you know, she has her.
Specifically, Grammy and your mom.
Yeah, and like, okay. Or like, oh, your family member. Like, she has you specifically as favorite brother.
All right, I'll just talk about Grammy and your mom for a second. So it was like having two moms, I would say, just because whenever Grandma wasn't there, your mom just helped me out with whatever I needed, rides, whatever, baseball stuff. They were all there for me. So actually, your mom got me my first computer, so that was cool.
She did.
Senior in high school, got one, so I could get my stuff done. You know, so she helped me with that. But yeah, it was. Everyone was always there for me.
What was it like going to Alma in high school?
Man, it was different every year. Just, you know, friends come and go, and you have some friends going into it your first year, and then, you know, everyone meets different people, so everyone just kind of goes separate ways. Luckily, I had like two or three really good friends I grew up with, so
that's nice.
I always kicked it with them. Shout out to Sokka, Anthony, Mike C, rest in peace. by the end of it, I was cool with pretty much everyone, and just learned about my business.
That's nice. What did you study in college? You went to Long Beach State, right?
Yeah, so changed my major a few times. So I started out wanting to do accounting for some reason. I don't know, I think because I took it in high school and I got an A, and I was like, I think I could do this. And then my first year, I was like, so I tried to switch it up to like business, like sports management type, but they really didn't have anything offered at the time, just in the master's program. So continued looking, and I tried to do like kinesiology, switch to that, but all that science.
What is that?
Oh, it's like you're studying. I want to be like a personal trainer.
Oh, okay.
Like an athletic trainer. Type. All that science and math, that wasn't for me, so switch it up again. I knew I had a knack for child care because I've always been around kids and all that stuff. So I found a major that I never even heard of. It's called Recreation and Leisure Studies. So I majored in that my third year, I think. That's when I first started taking classes there, and then it stuck.
Oh, you kept going with it?
Yeah, I met some cool people. Still friends with them to this day. So it was just like, it was perfect. Worked at some after school programs during college, helping kids out, and just built from there.
That's great. Yeah. So after Long Beach State, you got, were there any other jobs before the Hyatt?
Oh yeah. So let me see, my first year in college, I kind of got a little too crazy my first semester. You know, I was living the dorm life, but you know, whatever you think that is, and kind of got on some little academic trouble.
So did your grandma get mad? Like,
oh, I didn't even
tell
her.
You never told her?
So, now you know. So I had like, yeah, I came with probation for a semester. And then that summer, I got a job at City Industry, one of the factories for Robinson's May, which I don't know if you remember that store. It was a warehouse, and I kind of just put it on myself to like, hey, I'm gonna get a job where if college doesn't work out, I'm gonna see where this life leads. And it sucked. Working in the factory, unloading trucks, all that stuff. Luckily, the guy that hired me, he went to Long Beach State too, so he was kind of like, hey, this ain't for you. You need to go and get your stuff and get it together. So I did, and every semester after that, just GPA went up and up. So yeah, that was my very first job. Also worked at JCPenney's while I was in college. So I did that cashier stuff, folding clothes, all that stuff. Then I worked on campus while I was in college. So I did in the games area. So we had like pool tables, ping pong tables, bowling alley, like a candy store and stuff. So I was just hot. I was working there while I was in school. And then I got into hospitality. So I took a job as a banquet server at a hotel. That's not hype, so I'm not gonna mention it. Did banquet serving. So I worked Friday, Saturday nights for my last year of college, and while I was still working in the student union as well. So had a couple jobs, still in school and finishing my last year. And then once I graduated, moved back home. Was out here, let me see, I couldn't find anything for a couple months. And then a position opened up at the Hyatt Regency Huntington Beach, seasonal recreation attendant. So I don't know if you know what seasonal means.
Is that like you just work during the summer?
Yeah, so I was hired on for March and not expected to work past September. So I was just like, all right, once I'm going to get some experience in.
You liked it there? You really liked it?
Oh, I mean, once I was there, it was like, this is cool. You know, I was having to drive from La Puente to Huntington Beach. So that was a long commute for, you know, $8 an hour or whatever I was making. It's crazy. But once I got there, saw a lot of opportunity. You know, they didn't really do a whole lot in my in the recreation field there, just because they didn't have a whole lot of experience. So me coming in with my, you know, my degree in recreation, I already had this experience and just started floating ideas to them. They're starting to trust me, and then just that opened the door, and then they asked me to stay on after the summer as a full time, and did that. A couple years later, got promoted as supervisor, and then a couple years after that, promoted again. So just like it just grew from there.
When did you move there? Like, did you decide to move there?
Move to.
So you didn't have to drive somewhere.
Oh, so yeah, once I got promoted, because I was like sleeping on the couch at Grammy's house for a couple years. People waking me up all the time, so I didn't even have a room. So that was even more motivation to step my game up. And a couple years when I got promoted, then I was like, I gotta get out. So my friend June, who's up in the Bay Area right now, but I met him in college. He had a room open in Irvine, so I lived in Irvine for a couple years. And then after that, I found a place in Huntington Beach. I was there for a couple years, and then I moved to Lakewood after that. So Huntington Beach was like whatever, it was cool to be, but everyone's kind of just in their own bubble. It's hard, no one wants to get out of there.
What is it like deciding to move to Denver? Like, was it like a firm, like,
oh, no.
Or did it take time? No, like, you had to think about it a lot.
Oh, yeah. When I first like considered transferring to another area, one of the first things I said was, I don't want to be anywhere cold. I was like, I'm a transfer, I don't want to be nowhere cold, I don't want to be in the snow, and I go and deal with all that stuff. And I just, later on, when nothing was really opening up, I had to just suck it up and like, hey, if you want to move up, you got to do what you got to do. You got to suffer in the weather. So fortunately, when that position opened up in Denver, for it. And, you know, they took a chance on me, which is great. Appreciate them for doing that. And then once I got there, I actually enjoyed it. I enjoy the snow now, and like I'm been tripping over it. Mm-hmm. Just whenever it rains, you know, that's the rough stuff. But you never know when it's gonna rain, when it's gonna snow. The forecast is nothing, or you can't predict anything there. So,
what are you doing in Denver? Like, are you seeing anything to do?
Oh yeah, there's a ton to do. Whatever you want. I mean, they have something for everyone there. If you're a big music fan, they got a ton of venues. Like, if you want to go to shows, there's this big venue called Red Rocks Amphitheater, and it's like a man-made, like a combination nature-made, man-made arena outdoor venue where a ton of people do shows there, a ton of big bands. I'm actually hoping to catch Dirty Heads, because Dirty Heads are coming out, and they're running for each band, so, you know, I want to catch them. Sublime's going to be out there in June, hoping to catch them. But, so, yeah, music-wise, we're good. The mountains are, like, an hour and a half away. If you want to do snowboarding, skiing, if you're that type.
Hey, you live in, like, where, like, all the, you can see it, like, all the arenas, right? Like, all the stadiums?
Oh, from the hotel? Yeah. If you're high enough, you can see all three. You can see Pepsi Center. I don't know what they call Bronco Stadium now. It's not Sports Authority, but everyone still calls it Mile High there. Mm-hmm. And then Coors Field's right there too. So you can actually hit all three in one day if you want.
I heard you talking about like beers pretty big there too.
Breweries, yeah. Colorado's known for their beers. It's a brewery everywhere. I can't even say brewery. I don't know. I can't pronounce it. They make fun of me a little bit. So a ton of breweries. That's where they make their. That's where they get their money. So everyone loves beer up there, mm-hmm. And they do a good job with the food too. It's good to just be able to experience all that. Kind of a beer stop now, but what are you gonna do?
What's the biggest difference between Denver, the Hyatt over there, and the Hyatt here?
It's a big difference because the HB one, it's all resort atmosphere, so you got the beach across the way, you know, all these families just hanging out on property all day. Whereas the Grand, you got downtown, we're in the heart of downtown, 27 floors up, so really.
Also, it's like a. Like a
it's not like how you've seen it's all spread out. No, it's just one big building, just like 27 floors. So they can hang out there, but there's not much to do in a hotel other than, you know, a good restaurant and, you know, the fitness center and all that. But you go there just to experience what's around it. So during ski season, they'll stay at the hotel and go skiing, or they'll come for a ball game, or it's people like here on business. We get a lot of business groups.
Do you know what's next after Denver? Like, what do you want to do after that?
I do not. I kind of have an idea, but stuff changes so much. It's all about timing, especially in my field. The positions don't open as frequent as other positions, so I'm just focused on being as prepared as possible when that time comes. So when I feel like I've mastered what I'm doing now, then I'll start to look around and see. Hopefully it brings me back over here, but I'm open to wherever now.
Great.
Since I've been in the snow, it's crazy.
Welcome back to the BHB Trilogy Podcast, episode 14, here with David Hernandez and Buckets. And Buckets.
Oh, we hear you like to travel, right?
Yeah, traveling's awesome.
What has been the best experience from traveling to see the Raiders or Dodgers play?
Ooh, that's a good question. New Orleans probably would be the best when I went. It was week one, it was like a couple years ago, 3 years ago. You don't realize how many Raider fans are out there from all these different states. You walk down Bourbon Street, everyone has waving a different Raider flag. Mississippi, you know, has a different state and all that stuff. So it's cool meeting all these different people. And then the game itself was nuts. So it was like down to the wire at the end, Raiders scored. Down one, they could either kick the extra point, tie it up, or they go for two, no time left. Or it was like, a few seconds left. But went for two, got it, and we were just going crazy out there. You know, they just have that Houdat chant, so we just started saying who that, and they were saying Raiders. You know, we that. That's what we were saying, we that. But no, all the people were there were cool though. Saints fans, they love them some Drew Brees. If you say the wrong thing, they'll let you know. But it was a great experience there.
What has been the worst experience?
Worst experience. I mean, they've all been good, but just going, I guess.
Like obnoxious.
If anything, we were the obnoxious ones. it was all good. Like, everyone's cool when they see me. There's not really any knuckleheads. No one really gets out of hand. So, I haven't really had a bad experience. As long as you're being, you're all right.
How do the Dodgers bounce back from 2 World Series losses?
Bounce back? All right. Well, I mean, they're still up top, so I don't think they need to bounce back from anything. Mm-hmm. They'll be there. They just need to fix one or two things. I thought they fixed it with the bullpen over the offseason, but they're still struggling, so hopefully they figure it out. Definitely got a good right-handed bat with AJ Pollock. Doing well, so they got it all going. They'll be there again. So they just need to, bats need to come alive in the series.
You think Clayton Kershaw needs to retire?
No. Nope. Just switch it up a bit. You know, he's not a power pitcher anymore. He needs to go that Greg Maddux route, when the Braves back in the
who's
day.
That?
Who's that?
Yeah,
who's Greg that? Maddux? Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh. He used to play for the Braves, Cubs, Braves, but once he got older, all he did was paint the corners. So he just focused on placement of the ball, getting hitters out, so not worrying about strikeouts. And he turned that into a great career. So, but yeah, do your research, man. Look into Greg Maddux.
Buckets? Let me take
some. Well, so the Dodgers lose every time my mom goes to the playoffs. So we banned her from going to the game.
Banned her?
Yeah.
Yes. Well, maybe that'll work. Have you gone to a game where, since the ban, where she didn't go in that one?
No.
Oh, so
it's we also so the theory like hasn't. Season game. Playoffs, but no.
Theory hasn't been tested yet then. Mm-hmm. So this year when they go to the playoffs, she's not allowed. Man, that's crazy.
What's going on with the Lakers?
Question. What's up?
The Lakers, what's going on?
You know what's going on. They're doing their thing. It's all right. So,
what do you think when
LeBron coming turned out to not be what everyone thought it'd be. Mm-hmm. I mean, well, the smart ones knew that he was coming just for business, mainly for business purposes. That's what the whole thing was.
What did you think when we first signed him?
Happy, of course. He's the best player in basketball, but then you're like, oh no, but he's also got Space Jam 2, and he's doing all this other stuff, and it's like, how focused is he?
Did you hear that? Like, every time you ask a player, they turned it down? Like, he asked, like, Giannis, he turned it down.
Who asked him?
LeBron.
Oh, for Space Jam?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he's asking all the stars, the youngsters, and they don't want to deal with that. They got playoffs. They're focused. That's the difference. He needs to ask, like, who's in the league right now that's, like, older?
Vince Carter.
Vince Carter? Yeah, throw him
he's
in
like
there.
40-something.
He'll do it. He's on his last year, so.
Uh-huh.
What was that? All good. I don't know. We'll see what happens when the offseason coming up. Maybe they'll get some players coming in.
Hopefully.
I mean, it's not affecting the business, man. They got LeBron, top jersey sales?
Oh, yeah, he's first jersey sales.
Yeah, so from a business standpoint, they're solid. But the fans are just like, what's going on?
What do you think about Magic?
Oh, he just dipped out.
He just resigned.
Just dipped out overnight, didn't tell nobody. Mm-hmm. I didn't expect that, but, he wasn't all in either, so I guess that go.
And I was tweeting all this stuff, now that he resigned, he's like, free to say whatever he wants.
What's he saying?
He says, yesterday he said, the truth will come out eventually.
eventually.
That's cryptic. I don't know what that
and
means.
And then everyone in the comments was like putting like popcorn, like
that popcorn meme, that was funny. Or the guy with the chair when he flips the chair. I don't know what that means, so I guess we'll see.
Oh, you didn't hear?
Nah.
Supposedly, Rob Pelinka and Jeannie Buss were emailing each other on how bad Magic was doing.
What?
And he got CC'd on one of them.
What?
Yeah.
Who CC'd? Like blind copied? Or
yeah. Dang. Jeannie usually blind copies him on emails, and she accidentally blind copied emails where they're discussing Magic's poor performance.
Oh, man. That's some drama.
What's blind copy?
Like where you copy somebody, but they don't see it.
Yeah, so I could send you an email, and then I could blind copy Eli. You don't know that he's also seeing what I'm seeing in the email. But he could see it. You know what I mean?
But he can't, like...
He'll get the email, but you can't see that he received that he also got the email.
Oh, wait, so Magic saw all the emails?
So I guess they're talking. That goes whoop, whoop, and then... He saw. I don't know what they said, but I'm curious to find out.
That's interesting.
What do you think they said?
Yeah, what do you think they said?
So you're talking crap about his.
I think they're just
decision.
Mad. They're
just mad he left.
Because they traded D'Angelo Russell.
They traded D'Angelo Russell. He's averaging like 21. But I know the Julius Randle averaged 21.4 per game, and they let him go.
But do you think they're still going to be doing that? The Lakers?
Probably not.
Ingram and all them.
Mm-hmm. But like Lonzo's a bust. I don't care what anyone says.
Lonzo bust. He did well when he was on the court. I wouldn't call him a bust yet. How old is he?
Yeah, how old is he?
21, 22. I think he's like 20, 21 or something.
22.
They didn't call a little kid that a bust. Not yet. Maybe Darko. You can say that about Darko Milicic.
Yeah.
Ooh. He came out the same. Oh, you know who that is?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I wasn't sure. I don't know who Greg Maddux is.
What do you think of John Gruden? On the like, was it really disappointing this year?
Time will tell still. It's the second year in, so.
You still optimistic?
Oh, yeah.
You think it was just a fluke? Like, okay. This first
that was
year.
A fluke. Well, the office was running pretty well, so they just all those trades, you mixed up this personnel, roster, mix-ups, so they really got nothing consistent going.
Were you disappointed when they traded Khalil Mack?
Oh, yeah.
So you saw, like, the notification, you're like...
I bought his jersey, and I was like, they're not going to trade him, so I'm safe. Cause that's why I don't like buying jerseys, because they always get traded.
Mm-hmm.
But I was like, nah, this is a lock. They're going to sign him, buy his jersey, then they trade him.
So what'd you do with the jersey?
Oh, I got it still. I'm still working it. Yeah. It wasn't his fault, you know, whatever. So I still got the jersey. I'm not gonna game one.
Yeah.
So you know what? You're back in you're starting Alma, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what are you thinking?
Oh, I don't know.
When do you start? Next fall? Or are you doing summer school?
Yeah. I don't have to, but like they're making me.
They're making you?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
I don't know. Why are you making
me? Isn't that part of the program? No, you have to, my first year, I had to do summer. Well, I didn't do summer school. I did weight conditioning or whatever. Whatever you had to do for football.
Mm-hmm.
So you had to do some portion of summer school. But some people did it like just to get some early start on classes and then they were smarter. So. And you're smart. That's why.
So you grew up with Uncle Chewy, right?
Yeah.
Is he like, he's like pretty strict?
Always.
Hearing?
Always.
He's like the dean. He's like my dean.
Yeah, he's
like never get in trouble.
He's the dean of his life. Everything. He's going to be deans it up everywhere he goes. But yeah, so he's got ears, eyes everywhere. So that's what you got.
Yeah, because like, he's my dean, right? Yeah, so like.
He'll be your dean at some point. Yeah, just don't do anything stupid, you're good.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, he's got eyes everywhere.
He took away like Matthew's phone.
Yeah, he didn't even know what was going on, right? Mm-hmm. Like someone snitched on him or something. I don't know. I'm just saying, he's got people, so just be careful.
So you said like the draft was fine, right? You got everything you wanted?
got running back, got edge rusher, got safety. So far, so good. Got another pick today.
Beast mode retired yesterday.
Officially?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. He tweeted it? Or?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's, I'm guessing that's why they went for a running back. Beast mode, level, still there. Open, you know, not going nowhere.
So you're happy with Clint? Like, I hear, like, everywhere. Even when they drafted him, Clinton Farrell, everyone was like, what? Like, who is this?
Who is this? This, not so much who is this, but it's like, everyone projected him, like, mid-round.
Like, who?
15.
Who would you want to draft?
In my mock draft, because I made my own mock draft. So
oh,
I had him. Yeah, we get together, me and my friends, we get together, we do our own mock drafts, and we incorporate, you know, we do
some. Like, every round, everything?
Just the first round. So we hung out yesterday. Everyone chooses their pick. If you get it right, you get to.
What'd you get? Like, you had anything right?
Nah, I got five.
Oh.
5 out of 32. The winner got like 12. But, you know, we do our own thing, and I had him going like 17 or in there. So, they really loved him. They're not, he wasn't going to last to 24. So. They're like, we like him. He's top three edge rusher. They got him. They probably wanted to trade down, but no takers, so gotta do it. He's still good.
We should probably.
That's a player of the year, 2-time All American.
Really?
Yeah, he's got 2 rings. He's established. That Clemson line is crazy.
Yeah, like, didn't they like take half of them? Defensive line?
Yeah, 3 of them got drafted.
What'd you think about the Giants drafting Daniel Jones?
Oh, I had him. I had him in my mock, but for 17 or 18, whenever he was their second pick. So I knew I had the Giants picking them, but later in the round. So the fact that they got him at 6, that was crazy. I don't know. That was nuts.
You see when Dwayne Haskins laughed when they drafted him?
He laughed?
There's like a little clip, yeah. But like, Daniel Jones got drafted by the Giants. And then it shows Dwayne Haskins, and like he kind of laughed.
Like he's smirked. He's doing that.
He did. Like, I'll show you.
Maybe I don't know.
I'll show you. Look.
I don't know if he was unprofessional like that. Maybe they cut it to him like it was different. It was different time of the day or something. You like who the Packers get? They got a couple guys, right? Buckets. They got a lineman, I think, from Michigan, and then they got a safety.
I'm
ready? What's up?
I'm like watching
the trip. Yeah, you gotta make it fun. That's why we do our own mock drafts and stuff. We try to do it ourselves. So.
Ask Bolivar. You asked Bolivar.
Wait, did you hear? Did you see the Antonio Brown thing when against Juju?
Oh yeah, that drama. That was nothing. I don't really pay no mind. I don't think it's an issue or anything.
This is like.
Antonio Brown always talks on Twitter.
Oh.
It's not a big deal.
Over here. You saw that?
I mean, yeah, he shrugged. He's like, whatever. Shrug it off. I don't know. I think he wanted to go to Washington anyway, so. It's awesome. He's where he should be.
I hear people calling him overrated.
No. I don't know. Quarterbacks always get drafted higher than they should have, but that's just because they're quarterbacks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well,
what? Oh, what, so, LeVar?
Yeah, what is LeVar?
What is up with LeVar? I don't know. I stopped paying attention to him after the shoes never came out. I think he's working. He's like working on getting shoes to everyone still after 2 years. But no, I don't know what he's been up to.
Oh, the lawsuit. The guy.
Well, Lonzo has that lawsuit, right?
Yeah. That's
the
money.
Guy that's stealing money from. Mm-hmm. I don't know what LeVar's been saying. I thought he was being quiet.
Who's the Lakers' next head coach, and who they get in free agency?
The Lakers' next head coach.
Oh, I don't know. Didn't they? who they interview or who they talk
Tyronn
to.
Lue.
Tyronn Lue.
Jason
Kidd. Monty Williams, mm-hmm. right?
And Jason Kidd.
Jason Kidd.
I think they're all pretty bad, though. I mean, Tyronn Lue's not good.
Well, Lue and Kidd both been to finals.
I know, but like that's because Tyronn Lue had like LeBron and Kyrie.
Well, Kidd was as a player, but I don't know. Kidd's never been as a coach.
I mean, look what happened to the Bucks after they fired Kidd. Like, now they have like the best record in the NBA.
Yeah, we could say that for Mark Jackson too, but Mark Jackson created that culture with the Warriors, and then Steve Kerr took it over.
Yeah. Why not Mark Jackson?
I know, thank you, yeah. Mark Jackson might be, but he might not want to coach LeBron. I don't know.
I see. How come they don't want to coach LeBron?
He kind of coaches himself, I guess. I don't know. I don't know what the problem is. I don't know. Couldn't tell. I'm not really a big LeBron fan, so that's why. I've always been like that. Kobe for life. Yeah. It's all about that Mamba mentality. I think LeBron has it. Dame Lillard, you get him on the Lakers. I'm all for it.
Mm-hmm. Who's they getting free agency?
Who's out? Kawhi. Kawhi's free agent, right?
Can they get
Kawhi, KD, Kyrie,
can opt out.
Kemba Walker.
I think they get Kemba Walker and
Kawhi.
And then next year they get Anthony Davis.
Klay Thompson.
I think Kawhi and Klay are coming.
Kawhi and Klay?
Yeah.
Klay?
Why I think Klay? So. Klay's a SoCal guy, you know? His dad's down here. Family's down here.
How scary are the Clippers?
Well, I don't think so.
Jerry West?
Clippers?
Money? LA.
Yeah, they got money.
They got Jerry West. Everywhere he goes.
No, he gets him. I don't know. Kawhi, like Kawhi could play with LeBron. Mm-hmm. I don't know if Klay can. Klay probably can. He's a shooter.
Yeah, we need shooters. LeBron, that's why.
They don't really have a true shooting guard. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Kuzma's there, Ingram, like the small. I don't know. We'll see.
Yeah, it's like.
But I'm thinking Kawhi and Klay. Kind of set up on that.
I think Kemba, Kawhi, and the next year we get Anthony Davis.
Yeah.
Anyway, what do you think?
Yeah, you're a baller, right?
We're gonna get.
You like buckets?
I'm gonna get
Klay gets buckets. So do you like follow all the scores? Because you're a scorer. Mm-hmm. Who do you follow? When you're watching ball. Yeah, but like what positions are you watching more? You're watching like the guards, forwards.
Right.
You're a scorer, that's fine. I'm a scorer too. Threes, mm-hmm. I don't want to be in the paint. I don't want any bruises. Just find me on the outside, kick it to me, it's going in. Town, you. I played basketball like 3 times this week since I've been out here. Just shooting
like a park or something.
Yeah, these are guys I used to play with in Huntington Beach Tuesday and Friday mornings. So we get together. It's more of an old man's game, you know. So I'm kind of the younger guy. But they play, you know, they know how to play. It's all team play, you know, and it's not 1-on-5 ever. And if it is, that guy gets iced out. So I think it's all good. But yeah, I established myself as a shooter, so everyone knows when I get the ball, it's going up.
Is that it?
Okay. That's it? All right. Yeah, it's a good time. Yeah, let me know if you want to do a road trip to Denver and do podcasts up there.
Thank you for coming to our podcast.
You're welcome.
And that's it for the B.H.B Trilogy podcast, episode 14 with David Hernandez and Buckets.